Hello, everybody. It's Mr. Liquid Bread coming at you with another beer review. Tonight I'm inside and doing kind of a later night beer review, so the lighting's usually not that great out in the old pit garage. So I got some lighting set up here, and we're here inside the house. So tonight we're doing I'm going to do a review of a beer from a brewery that's pretty young. It started out in 2008, so it's only a couple years old, and it's the typical story of how a microbrew company came about. A few guys got together and had been brewing in their garage for a while and decided to open up a microbrewery, you know, blah, 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 that whole thing. Tonight, though, we're going to go with a brewery that's not typical, or I should say a city that's not typical of microbrewing. We're just getting out of the whole Michigan scene right now, which is where I'm located. And we're not going to go on the East or West Coast, which is where you typically find a lot of the really good microbreweries. We're going to go dead center in the middle of the United States with a brewing company out of Omaha, Nebraska. This we're going with brewery tonight. It's called Lucky Bucket. It's right out of Omaha, Nebraska. Actually, I should say, if I want to be specific, in one of the suburbs of Omaha, it's in La Vista, Nebraska. Kind of sounds like a California town, La Vista.
La Vista.
La Vista.
La Vista, baby.
But again, it's called Lucky Bucket Brewing Company. And I actually did a beer tour there. Here's a couple pictures that I had there. The brewery's not very big at all. One thing I do want to note out is that one of the brewers went to Edinburgh, Scotland, and did some studying there with some brewmasters there, and actually has devised, apparently he's got a patent on some kind of distilling process where it has different levels of distilling, which is kind of interesting. If you know anything about distilling and how it works, I won't get into the nuts and bolts of how that works, but basically he's got different valves at different levels of the distilling process where he can release some of the alcohol at different levels of the distilling process, and it's actually kind of neat. Apparently he's got a patent on it, and they are, like a lot of microbreweries nowadays, are starting to brew their own rum and vodka, which is kind of neat. But they start off primarily with beer, and as you can see here, here's their label. I'll throw that up on the screen there. Really nice label, very unique. A little tidbit that I found out from the brewery tour that we had there. Lucky Bucket, the name of the brewery, actually apparently came from the company before they started out. They had provided a survey to the community on what are some good names, and they gave them a list from their marketing department of what they thought were good names for the company. And apparently Lucky Bucket was the marketing department's worst guess. They just hated it. It unfortunately came back as the number one voted response from the people that they sent this survey out to. And the story behind Lucky Bucket, for those of you who don't know, back in the 20s, before Prohibition, it was very common for anybody, if you had beer, you want to go get some beer from your local pub, you'd grab your bucket and you'd walk down the street to your local pub and have them fill it up with your favorite beer that they brewed and take it back to your house and drink it. Yeah, that's kind of flat, probably, and it'd be like an open growler, I guess. Just taking a growler back that never got sealed and just drinking it all that night, I guess. I guess they drank a lot of beer. So that's where they got their name, Lucky Bucket Brewing Company. Again, their label's very nice, very unique. I really like the style of this label. I think their labels vary depending on what beer you buy or you're drinking. This particular beer that we're going to be drinking from Lucky Bucket Brewing Company is their IPA. It's an original American India Pale Ale. It just says full hop flavor, craft brewery, established in 2008. It's a 6.3 ABV. Little stuff on the side here says it's no secret that IPA still is all about the hops. American craft brewers have become especially adept in the ways the humulus, that's a big word for a side of a bottle, humulus lupulus can be used to make a spectacular beer. Sorry if I spit there. A spectacular beer for hop heads to enjoy. Our original American IPA celebrates this interesting diversity in hot flavor. The final result is big, bold, and shall we say, in your face, as it should be. I like that. I like that last line. That's nice. In your face, as it should be. Very nice. Like, again, I love the label, and I'm going to go right up to the cap here, and you know what? I'm also going to give them plus one for the cap, because this cap is awesome. You know, they've got this script LB on there that says, stands for Lucky Bucket, handcrafted, blah, 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 and it is a screw-off cap, which is nice. So you don't have to use a bottle cap opener, which I actually traditionally keep it old school. I like the bottle cap and opener, but in this case, good old screw off. So, good head. And I've been shaking it around a little bit. Oh, did you see that? Little bubbles popping. It's nice. Good carbonation. I've been messing around with it a little bit. Going with the Lucky Bucket glass. Now, unfortunately, this glass is not frosted, so pulled it out here at the last second, so I apologize. But needless to say that you'll still be able to see the wonderful color of this nice beer. Oh, dribbled a little bit on the table. Great, great color if you can see that. Nice amber color. Good carbonation. The head is a nice light brown, actually. Not brown like in a nut brown ale, but it's got a little brownish color to it, or a little amber hue to it. It's not a typical white hue. And this has got hops rolling right off the head. Great hop smell coming off the head. My mouth is starting to water. This is one of those, I'm anticipating this to be one of those beers that just rips into my taste buds and just screws up all my taste buds because it's so hoppy and so dry. And I love those beers, and I'm anticipating that's what this is going to be. Head's dying a little quick. Might be because I've got a warm glass instead of a cold glass. Beer whisperers out there.
And I just want to take a moment, if you don't mind, to see what the beer has to say to me. Every beer has a whisper, has a soul and a spirit. I just want to see what that has to say.
Actually, I do mind.
The beer is not really saying jack to me. So, yep, the head actually died pretty quick, but let's take a sip. That is a very, very hoppy beer, just like I thought. Typical IPA, a lot of hops, a lot of dryness on the tongue. You know, the hops is overpowering. You don't get a lot of flavor from anything else as far as the malt or anything like that. Very good. Very good beer, though. The one thing that I do like about this is a lot of hops, and it's very crisp, very clean tasting. There's no aftertaste of any other kind of flavors. It's just like what they said here on the bottle. What did they say here? The final result is big. It's bold, yep, we got a big, bold hops taste. And shall we say, in your face. In your face! It is indeed in your face. I have had hoppier beers, so don't get me wrong, but this is definitely on the hoppy scale, if you've ever had a Mad Hatter IPA from New Holland Brewing Company, that is a very hoppy, that's been one of my hoppiest beers I've ever had. I love that beer, but it'll tear your taste buds right up, taste your palate's toast afterwards. This isn't quite as hoppy. It's still got a great, strong hoppiness, don't get me wrong. And it's amazing that this brewery out of Omaha, you don't think of Nebraska as being a big microbrew capital or center. It's got some good lacing, by the way, on the side there. Again, it's all hops. Oh, hops. All hops, no malt. Let's get this slammed. Let's get it rated. Let's get back to the football game. So here it is. Cheers. That is a good... that's a good slammable IPA. IPAs are hard to find that you can slam. Don't know if I'd slam a bunch of those. It's making my eyes water. But I didn't gag on it. It went down pretty smooth. Again, a lot of that hoppiness, but not overpowering to the fact the point of when you've got to almost sip it because it's so dry. But again, not a lot of other flavors coming out there. You know, I don't got any malts, any specialty grains flavor. But this is the IPA from Lucky Bucket Brewing Company. I believe they have a Oktoberfest they do around this time of year. And they have a, they possibly have another, I think they have a lager. A lager that they usually, they brew along with the IPA that's, yeah, they have a Prohibition, it's called Pre-Prohibition Lager. Another one, I don't know, again, I don't know if I have one of those. And they also have a Certified Evil Ale, which I heard is excellent. It's a strong ale. It's got a silver award from the World Beer Championships in 2009. So it's heinously good is what they call it. And you don't hear that word very often, heinously. Back to the beer in question. This is, again, Lucky Bucket Brewing Company. Label's awesome. Cap is awesome. Brewery story is awesome about how they got their name Lucky Bucket. Awesome name. I just think that's very... Their marketing department needs to get a plus 1 points for this. And this is a great beer. Pretty good fall beer. Maybe even a summer beer to start off with. Because it doesn't have a lot of those other flavors, it's mostly just that IPA flavor, I'm probably going to give it about a 7 or 8. Let's ride the fence. Let's go with an 8. Let's go with an 8, definitely, because the overall package and the beer quality is great. It's a good IPA. The only reason I'd give it a lower score is just because there wasn't overly hoppy, which to me I like, and there wasn't a lot of other flavors that sometimes breweries will add in there. That'll come out some specialty grains, maybe some kind of malt taste. It's basically just a real hoppy beer. So, but it's very crisp and clean. There's no aftertaste of any other ill effects. It's a real good beer. So once again, Lucky Bucket Brewing Company out of La Vista, Nebraska, or the greater Omaha, Nebraska area. And this is their IPA. Coming from Mr. Liquid Bread, we're giving it an 8 here on Mr. Liquid Bread. Enjoy your NFL and college football games this fall. And I'll be trying to get back to you every week with another beer review. Have a good night.